The next topic is performance measurements. The performance measurements means we can find out the performance of the any algorithm. How to calculate the performance of the algorithm? The performance of the algorithm is mainly depending on the space and time complexities. The performance is mainly depending on the space and time complexities. The space complexity means how much space is needed for storing the given algorithm values. The time complexity means how much time is needed to compute the given algorithm. And if we take the space and time complexities, the space and time complexity is mainly depending on the compile time and the run time. This is mainly depending on the compile time and the run time. But if we take the measurement is mainly depending on the run time of the algorithm. The compile time means if you are taking any program, that program must be compiled only once. Say whenever you are executing the program number of times, it will be run the program only, it will not compile every time. So the measurement of the performance is mainly depending on the run time of the process. So depending on the runtime, how to measure these performance? This is mainly comes under the what is the time it will be takes? How much time it will be take for find out the process? So that is the short time or long time or which time it will be considered. So these must be done through the one example. You want to calculate these through one of the example. So in that I am giving the one example. That example is comes under the sequential search. So what is comes under the sequential search? Okay, now we will discuss about the sequential search. Okay, now we will discuss about through the sequential search. The algorithm for sequential search is sequential search of a comma x comma n. A represents the array of elements. X represents the what is the element you want to search. N represents the number of elements. That means in that we can take the one array of elements. Within the array of elements, we can find out that element is existed or not. So that is comes from the sequential search. The sequential search means you can sequentially search the each and every element, that element is existed or not. So the algorithm is comes under the I equal to n. So first of all, you can initialize the n value to the I. A of 0 is equal to x. So what is the element you want to found? That element is stored under the A of 0. While A of I is not equal to x. So first you can start from the n elements. See, if A of n is not equal to x, you can go to this process. I equal to I minus 1. If it is equal to x, you can return the n value. So this is the process of the sequential search. Okay, now we will take one example. 5, 4, 6, 8. These are the elements. Now I want to find out the element x, that is 4. We can apply this to this one. In that I equal to n, that means I equal to n means 4 elements. So a of 0 equal to x. In that a of 0 equal to 4, the element 4. While a of I is not equal to x, first one is a of I means a of 4, that equal to x. That means a of 4 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. 8 equal to 4? No, it is not equal to 4. If it is not equal to 4, now we can decrement the I, that means 4 minus 1, that equal to 3. Again, you can go to the loop. A of 3 equal to x or not. A of 3 means 6. 6 equal to 4. 6 is not equal to 4. So again you can decrement the value. That means 3 minus 1, 2. A of 2 equal to x. So A of 2 value means 4. 4 equal to 4. Yes. So whenever this is equal, then you can return the value of n. So now n value is 2. So at the time of 2, we can find the element. So sequentially you can search the element. So the performance is depending on the how much time it will be take for find out the element of this one. So this is the process of measuring the any elements. So if you want to measurements in that, you must apply the asymptotic notations. Using the asymptotic notations, you can find out the what is the measurement you are having. In asymptotic notations, you are using the big O, big omega, big theta. So using the three notations, you can find out the complexity of the given algorithm. So this is the process of performance measurements.